Part of what makes the system seem so impossible is that it defies our understanding of probability and influence over future events. And I'm going to show you something now which is impossible in exactly the same way. And that is to toss a coin fairly 10 times in a row and have it come up heads every time. Now, we film this under control conditions with multiple cameras that won't cut away, and it's a genuine coin with heads on one side and tails on the other. But I want you to watch this and try and work out how it can be possible, because the key to understanding this is the key to understanding the system. 10 heads in a row.
Watch.
One. That's heads. Two, that's heads. Three, heads. Heads, that is four. Heads, five. Six. Four more to go, and I'll stop. Seven. Three more. Eight. Nine heads. Last one. Ten. 10 heads in a row. Thank you very much indeed. I'll show you later on exactly how that's possible. But for now, I need to take what I'm doing with the coin and apply that to the horse races so that I can predict again and again the results of the races and convince Khadisha that my system really works. Now, I'm not the first person to try and come up with a horse racing system. It's been attempted in the past, but it has never, ever worked. My system, though, is the first system that guarantees a win over and over again. And later on, I'm going to show you how.
It wouldn't be easy for a punter to make a living out of horse racing.
Two Greys, Classic Crocker on the outside of Corellian as they go towards the third.
There can't be a system. You're dealing with an animal. It's not a machine. You can't set it. If he comes out of the stable the wrong side in the morning, he might not be winning his race.
Nation State jumped it better over the creek, behind them in predicament, and swiftly on defence number five.
Well, if somebody said to me they had a system, it's rubbish.
Really, there's only one winner, and the bookmaker's the winner.
If there was a winning system, there would be no bookmakers.
When we come to work, we come out with a load of cigars when we work, because we know at the end of the day we're going to celebrate with a nice cigar on the way home, so all you punters are going to lose all your money. That's what we come here with.
Just a bit keen to go a bit faster, the Grey.
To find a system that will change your life is what we're talking about. That is definitely improbable. And even if you think you've found it, having the guts to back that up and putting down large sums of money to make it change your life is another step forward altogether.
Imperial Commander over it in front from Nation State in second place. Blundering back in third was Karenin, but he had tired horse now. Imperial Commander, the odds-on favourite, comes up the hill, storms up the hill towards the final fence here, and he comes towards it, jumps it well. Tony Evans, the Imperial Commander, 10 lengths clear of a Nation State in second place. There's a decent battle for third over the creek, maybe the one for that, but Imperial Commander, having won here last month, makes it 2 out of 2, another winner here at Cheltenham.
After 4 wins in a row, it's time for Khadisha to experience the excitement of a live horse race. And while she gets ready for that, I wanted to convince the experts, against their instincts, that maybe it is possible for a system to really exist. I arranged to meet some racing experts to test out some of my ideas and hopefully convince them that I could indeed have a reliable system. Phil Bell is the manager of Fontwell Park Racecourse. Katie Stevens is the manager of Hereford Racecourse. James Pyman is a journalist and tipster for the Racing Post. Jim Boyle is a racehorse trainer and a council member of the National Trainers Federation. Can I get you to mix up those four envelopes for me? Just get them a mix. And if you can stick these on yourselves, they peel off and you can put the backings in your pocket if you like. Thank you very much. Just put one of those on you each. And if you grab one of those as well, thank you. Have an envelope too. You've all been interviewed about this idea of there being a system and whether it's possible to predict the horses accurately, and predictably you've all sort of said no, it's not. It's not possible. I would say that it's massively unlikely, but by no means impossible to have a system that would work.
A mathematician worked out
the probability of having a system that would accurately predict a winning horse every time is it's 1.48 billion to one. Hugely unlikely, as good as impossible, but not impossible, that's the point. Actually just massively improbable. So what I'm going to do is to ask you to sort of step into this world of people here. There are 500 Polaroid pictures, and these are just members of the public. And I'm going to ask you to each go and select one of these pictures. It's just really important as you do this that it is a random selection. So please don't let what the people look like, you know, how attractive or unattractive they are. Don't let any of that influence you. Some of the, you know, if any of the names happen to remind you of people that you know, again, none of that is to influence you at all. These have to be random selections. That's very important at this point. What I would say is, by doing this, I am showing you how my system works. It'll make more sense to you when you watch the program back, and you'll understand what I mean. Please have a good look around at them all. You see they're all different. Take as long as you like. When you've got one, just stand by it and let me know that you've chosen one. But take as long as you like. Feel free to have a good wander around first. The pictures themselves have long numbers on the back, but don't worry about those for now. Those will be important later on. Take your time. Just put your hand up when you've chosen one and... Okay, great, lovely. All got one?
Yeah.
Excellent, thank you very much. Unclip the pictures, just take them off the string. There's a couple of little pegs on each one. Lovely. So bringing your picture with you, what I want you to do, not quite yet, what I tell you to, is to come and stand on one of these four black spots that there are here on the ground. So if you come and do that for me now, any one of these four. Excellent. Thank you very much indeed. So there are 500 pictures there. You've each got one. You've come back and stood on one of these spots each, thus putting yourself in a different order, and chosen large. I mean, it is by chance, it is random, apart from the fact that whoever was closest, whoever took a picture from closest, would have had the choice of any one of the four to stand on probably the lad, the choice of any one of the four to stand on probably the